So my name's Kirsty Ogg, and I'm director of New Contemporaries. And New Contemporaries has been around since 1949, supporting artists just at the point that they are emerging from higher arts education. So the last time we were in Hull, I'm very ashamed to say, is 1964. It's absolutely brilliant to be back. And I think, you know, one of the motivations for that was really sort of seeing the partnership work that was established when the Turner Prize came here in 2017, you know, and the relationship between the organisations in Hull, between Ferens Art Gallery and Humber Street. And we just really wanted to you know, work with that network, and that network wanted to work with us. So, you know, our main partners are Ferens Art Gallery and Humber Street Gallery. And of course, we're extending out the reach of the show to include other organisations in Hull, ArtLink, 87 Gallery, and Ferrell Art School. Britain has an incredible network of, you know, exhibition spaces right across the country, you know. There are artists all over the UK. You know, not everything happens in London. You know, there's artist communities everywhere. And I think it's really important for us that we're tapping into that network and working with that network, because we're drawing applicants for our open submission, nationally touring exhibition from all over the country, from, you know, from the four countries. I think, you know, what's really interesting is this is the cohort of artists that really, you know, made work during lockdown, and I think that the challenges around that are really, really apparent. There's sort of two main approaches to work, or sort of bodies of work represented in the show. One is all about domestic interiors, domestic objects, self-portraits, portraits of friends, you know, things that have obviously been made at home. And the other kind of main body of work is absolutely projecting beyond that, beyond the home environment, the kind of the confines of lockdown, thinking about spaces beyond that, imagined futures, alternative realities, how life, the world could actually be reimagined and reconfigured in different ways. And part of that is driven by politics, part of that is sort of driven by spirituality and alternative beliefs. We play a really important function for artists just at that really crucial point that they're leaving arts education, you know, whether that's a formalised degree awarding programme or whether it's an alternative programme. And we're really aware of the challenges, you know, that artists face if they want to go to art school, attached to the cost, you know. So there's some real access issues and sort of barriers, you know. And when you leave, you know, whatever type of education you're leaving, it's like a cliff edge. You go off because you suddenly lose access to the peer network that you've maybe established over a few years. You lose access to the conversations about your work. You maybe lose access to a working space to work in, access to resources, libraries, workshops, all of those things. So, you know, New Contemporaries actually forms a function of something that artists can kind of gather around. You know, they can rebuild a network, and it's really important for us that we're offering other forms, you know, of support. So in addition to the show, have a whole program of mentoring, studio bursaries, residencies, commissioning opportunities, fellowships, you know, that we offer artists. And it's all about, you know, just trying to help them over that first 5 years on leaving arts education, which is a really difficult one to just keep motivated, to keep, you know, to keep going. Because being an artist, it's a lonely path to tread.